many good things happening that is concerning the pandemic. So we're praying for you, and we're praying for all of our congregations. Amen. I have a, I want to read in your hearing that is this morning, that is Psalms 101, and I want to read from the 7th verse. It says that he that worketh deceit shall not dwell within my house. He that telleth lies shall not tarry in the sight of God. He that worketh deceit shall not dwell within my house, and he that telleth lies shall not tarry in the sight of God. Father, we thank you once again. That is for another Sunday, another service. And God, as we come and as we work and as we traffic, that is, through the week, we know that you're with us. And we know that today you're going to be with us. We come to worship you, that is, in spirit and in truth. We come to worship you, that is, in the beauty and splendor of holiness. And we ask, oh God, that you would cover us, bless us in a special way, and we'll thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen. Sister Tanya Henry is going to come to us at this time with praise and worship.
Amen. Good morning, Joseph Campbell. Would you be free from the burden of sin? There is power in the blood.
Songwriter said there's wondrous working power in the blood of the Lamb. And I thank God for that power. I thank God for the spirit that he's given us whereby we can live with that kind of power within our lives. Power that is to tread on scorpions, and power to talk to the demons while they're shaking their shoes. And we thank God this morning for all of the power that he's given. For thine is the kingdom and the power that is forever. We thank God. It's time for prayer now. And we know without a shadow of a doubt that prayer is a time whereby we can all come together and touch bases with God. And I imagine sometimes when we say, let us go to the throne of grace, and when people are screaming live and they say that, and all over America, people are praying. And isn't it amazing that God can just hear everybody's requests? That is, at the same time, we serve a great, big, and a wonderful God. And I thank God for that. Amen. Our prayer song is going to come to us now. Amen. Come on, Sister Tanya. And then we're going to ask our brother Ted Henry to come and lead us again in prayer.
Father, we just thank you. We praise you one more time. As you let us come, Lord, to see another day, we thank you, Lord, for health and strength. And God, we know that there's healing in your word. We thank you again, Lord, for just Lord, the desire, Lord, to lift up your name, Lord, as we see so many things happening, Lord, in this world on today. We recognize, Lord, if it had not been for the Lord who was on our side, we don't know where we'd be on today. But thanks be to God. You have blessed us, Lord, to come to this sanctuary, to come to this tabernacle, to give you praise and to give you honor, Lord. We thank you and we praise you. Now, God, as we go forward into this service, we pray for the word that's going to go forth. Bless and anoint the word from our pastor, that, Lord, someone's life will be touched. Someone's life will be changed. God, we just continue to thank you and we praise you. For it's in Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Break every chain, break every chain, break every chain.
the chain breaker, the trap breaker. He has broken every chain, and we do thank God for that. I thank God for you this morning, all of our viewers and those who are looking in on us at this time as we stream live. We thank God that we are here once again, and we thank God that we are still alive. I thank God for his word, and I actually believe that it's going to take the word in order for us to be changed, in order for us to go to heaven or to get to heaven. It's going to take God's word. I believe in it, and I've been preaching it for a long time, and now is not the time to turn back, especially when the times are turbulence, and that is, there's trouble all around us. You understand? When John was on the Isle of Patmos, he said, there's trouble all around us, but guess what he said? I'm not troubled, and I want to be just like John when there's trouble all around us. Amen. We want to talk about lying. Like when a person tell a lie, that needs to be talked about. It really does, you understand. And according to Psalms 101:7, it says that a liar will not tarry in the sight of God. Now, a lying is one who makes a false statement, amen, with the intention to deceive, an intentional, that is, untruth it is. It's a falsehood. It's a falsehood. You're trying to deceive somebody. Now, out of the seven things, amen, the deadly seven things that God hates, he said that he hated a lying tongue. A lying tongue. Proverbs, that is 12:22, it says that a lying lips, amen, are an abomination unto the Lord. But they that deal truthfully, amen, is his delight. Revelations, that is 21:8, says, but the cowardly, the unbelieving, the abominable, not only that, but the murderers and sexual immoral, the sorcerer, the idolater, amen. It says, and all liars shall burn in the lake of fire and brimstone, and they shall have what they call a second death. Now, he threw lying and liars in that group for some reason or not. Proverbs 13:5, it says that the righteous hates what is false. Everybody ought to hate what is false, especially if you are for real. You ought to hate whatever is false. But now the wicked make themselves a snitch, and it brings shame to themselves. Amen. To the person that lies, you'll always bring an ocean full of shame, that is, in disgrace upon yourself. Amen. Because the biggest lie you can tell is the one that you do what? Tell yourself. And we can't start, amen, talking, not recognizing that we are doing something wrong, that is, or we're not doing something wrong, you understand, when we tell a lie, you see. Lying is not exaggeration. It's not using hyperbole, you understand. But the scripture tells us to beware of the good liars. I mean, there are good liars out there in America. They were called back in the day false prophets. False prophets. And we were taught, amen, that a statement you make, it either can be a lie or it can be the truth. Amen. It can be either true or false. You remember back in the day when you was in middle school and you took tests. And I remember taking the true or false test. And they would have a block. Y'all remember that? You put a T in it if it's true, and you put a F in it if it's false. Amen. And we took tests like this, believe it or not. And there will always be a true and false prophet that's hanging around. First Peter, that is 2:1. It says that there will be false teachers among you, and they will bring, the destruction heresies. They won't even mention the dying, that is, of our Lord and the Savior Jesus Christ, because they're blasphemers, and they're blaspheming, that is, the truth. They're exploiting, that is, the word of God, you understand. They're using false words. Amen. They're good liars that will deceive you. Amen. And will put you to shame. And we need to beware of those people. Now, that means that a lie will be told. A lie will be fabricated every day, every minute, every hour in our life. A poll was taken, and it says that Most people, it didn't say Christians now, but it says that there are people in America that tell as many as 24 lies in a month. In a month. There are people, you know, that they're called compulsive liars. And now they actually have these people filmed, and they're on TV and social media. They'll tell a lie, and then they'll act just like they have not said one thing. Amen. Many lies are told during this time. Say why, Pastor? Because this is tax season. Oh, you don't want to fool with that. Everybody ready to go home now. You understand? This is tax season. And there's some people who have only one child, you understand? That they place in on their income tax and all of that, their tax return, and then they'll go to sleep one night and wake up and it's time for taxes. They say, do you have one child? They say, no, I got triplets. That's what they do. Believe it or not, they actually do. People are lying at this time, you understand? Now the word of God in 2 Timothy chapter 1, it says that, know this also. Amen. That in the last days, perilous times are going to come, and people shall be lovers of themselves, lovers of money, you understand, proud, boasters, blasphemers, disobedient to their parents, unthankful, unholy, amen, without natural affection, truth breakers, false accusers, incontinent, fierce, and not only that, but despisers of those that are good, traitors, heady, high-minded, lovers of pleasure more than the lovers of God, having a form that is of godliness but denying the power thereof. For such turn away, he says, that is from God. Now, Paul is not only speaking, that is in that particular time, in that particular day, but Paul is speaking to us right now. He's speaking to the church. Now, the church folk has no business lying. The preachers have no business lying. Amen. But Paul is talking to us today. Amen. There will come a time, you understand, whereby, believe it or not, you're going to have to be real careful about what you say and what you do. Because the church is not designed for you just to feature yourself and to focus in on yourself. You understand? How many of y'all know what I'm talking about? Now, years ago, they said that people who would go in those booths and would take pictures of themselves over and over again, they were stuck on themselves, and they were called narcissists. That's what they were, you understand. But today, we have to be careful, and there's nothing wrong with it, but today it can be called Facebook, because people focus on themselves. Am I right? On Facebook. Many people cannot accept the truth of the Bible. Many people are going to tell an untruth after they have done something wrong. It's easy to go to a place of repentance and contrition, but they're not going to do that, but they would rather hold to the lie because they tell a lie because they're trying to do what? They're trying to protect their own, themselves. And this is why people focus in on themselves. Now, many people, amen, as I said, cannot accept the Bible that says in 2 Timothy 3:7 that we are ever learning, but we're never coming to the truth. Amen. And this is in red writing. It means that Jesus said this. He said that, and we shall know the truth, and the truth shall make us free. In St. John 8:32, amen. He said that, you know, to tell you the truth, that's a wonderful promise that God has given us, to know truth. Let the truth make you free. Tell the truth. Tell the truth every day. Amen. Amen. That needs to be taken seriously, especially as a child of God, especially when we feel and we need the kind of healing that need to come. Healing is not going to come unless you tell the truth. Why do people lie? That's a good question. Why do people lie? They lie to avoid the punishment or to hide in an awkward situation, or they lie to try to save their own. Amen. With a liar, nothing they heard or said can be true. So you have to be very careful. Amen. You see, lying diminishes the truth between you and another human being. That's why lying to your spouse is not a good thing to do. Believe it or not, it is not a good thing to do. One of our leaders that has just gone out of leadership, one of our top leaders. If you ask me, he was one of the linest person I ever heard in my life, and I ever seen that is in my life. Some people withhold the truth, believe it or not, but you cannot constantly just lie, especially on a national level when we have social media that knows what you said on yesterday. They can just show it to you. But some people, they just keep on lying. And people will withhold the truth. They'll try to suppress the truth, you understand, believe it or not, because they don't want to come out straight with the truth and to share it with other people. Amen. If you tell lies, you understand, you're going to have to fabricate another lie in order to help the first lie that you told. And you're going to spend your lifetime fabricating lies. But be careful. One sin gives birth to another sin. One lie gives birth to another lie. Amen. You remember Abraham. Abraham was in the Bible, and he told King Abimelech that his wife was his sister. He lied. And King Abimelech was getting ready to do what? Marry, believe it or not, his wife. You understand? But God intervened. You understand? You see, God intervened, and he stopped everything. And I thank God for that. That's a wonderful thing. We just can't spend a lifetime lying. You understand? Look at your income tax and tell the truth. It's okay if you had to pay a little bit back and tell the truth. If you've been paying it to the church, you wouldn't have to worry about paying anything back. Am I right about that? John 8:44, it says, and not only that, but we have a phrase that we like to say, the devil is a liar, and he is, believe it or not. But John 8:44 said, you come from your father, the devil, and if Jesus is not your father, amen, then Satan in the Bible has to be your father, believe it or not. The Bible says you are not sons and daughters, and you're not bastards either. Neither are you with Christ, amen, but you are with the devil. The devil was a murderer from the beginning. He has never been truthful. Am I right about that? And when the devil tells a lie, he does it naturally. In other words, he don't care. He don't care. You understand? You see, he's not only a liar. The Bible said he's the father of lies. The devil is more what? He's more than just what we call a symbol, a metaphor. The devil is real, believe it or not. And he loves it when you don't believe in him. When you don't believe in him, he just loves that. Amen. And you can do what? And you cannot serve God spiritually, believe it or not, especially when it comes down to living for God and growing in grace and in knowledge. You can't serve him, you see. And we have a lot of people because they really, really want to serve the devil. They're rubbing crystal balls, and they're reading horoscopes and all kinds of things. They're doing things like that. They want to read your palm and all of that. You see, and the devil is trying hard to make it dark before dawn, and he's doing a good job. Amen. Because nobody believes in the devil anymore like we used to. Amen. You see, the devil used to sneak around, and he had to do what? Hide out and all of that. But guess what people do today? They just open the door and let him right on in. Say, come on in. Come on in. You see? Now, the word devil, it means deceiver. That is, deceiver of who? The whole world. He deceives the whole world. Deceiver, you understand. Also, it means accuser. He accuses you day and night, you understand. All the time he's just accusing you before God. Amen. The word devil also means slanderer. Slanderer. Amen. Slanderer. He slanders you. You see? Slander, it means that he questioned a person's character. Amen. And when he look at you, he make them look worse than what they really are. Sometimes the people think that the devil is on their side, but he's not. He's not. If you don't believe it, ask some of those people who went on Capitol Hill on the 6th of the month of January. Ask them. You know what I mean? The devil is not. Oh, Lord, have mercy. The devil is not for you. He's against you. Well, Psalms 107, it says not only that the devil is a liar, amen, but he who practices deceit, amen, shall not be a part of my house, the Lord said. The liar, they'll hide one thing, you understand, in order to speak of another. You see, you're always going to hear about a liar saying something that's not quite the truth. There's no such thing as a half-truth. You have to tell the whole truth. You understand? The liar will not tarry in the sight of God. He will not linger. He shall not tarry, abide. He shall not be there in the presence of God. Amen. You will not tarry in my sight. Amen. You're going to do what? You're not going to rest, lodge. You're not going to stop. You understand? There's something that God just has against a liar that he hates. Because he said, you're not going to even tarry. That is in my sight. And the flip side of this is that he tells you to depart, to leave. You shun. You understand? Move away from me. You understand? You need to rush on. You understand? This is not a place whereby you sojourn. You understand? But I'm so glad that God, in 2 Timothy 2:19, he says, nevertheless, the foundation of God stands sure, and God knows everybody that belongs to him, believe it or not. He knows when you're sleeping. He knows when you awake. He knows about your uprising, your downsetting, your going out, and your coming in. He knows about all of that, and he knows when you're telling a buck naked, bold-faced, low-down, dirty, deceitful lie. God knows you. And you're not going to get away. Lying in the church. Lying to the church folk. Church folk lying to one another. A liar is already defeated because you're going to do what? You're going to get caught in your own lies that you tell. You understand? One great preacher said, he said that, you understand, that a lot of people that he met in his lifetime, you understand, a lot of them would not tell. They would not tell the truth. You understand? And they were overlooking this text in this scripture that says a liar will never tarry in the sight of God. So you may as well get ready to do what? Tell the truth. Tell the truth. The truth won't set you free, but it'll make you free. If you set me free, you can shackle me again. But if I'm made free, you remember Nelson Mandela? Oh, he was in jail for years. But in South Africa, they made the people set him free. After 27 years, he walked around just like a man that had never, nothing had never happened to him. He even looked like he had never been in jail. He looked like Shabako. He looked like he'd never been sick. That's right. But a liar, you will not tarry. You won't make it. And that's all I'm saying. This is the time of year where we need to check ourselves. You really need to check yourself. And remember what I said about the income tax. If you would give a little bit more to the church, maybe you could file and get something back. Well, I don't file what I give to the church. That's okay. Just keep on giving to the church. And we thank God. Amen? Amen. Brother Ted is going to come at this time.
Amen. We thank God for that word on today. We thank God that we realize that lying is a spirit, a lying spirit. I think we've talked about a lying spirit. But we thank God that we can, as Christians, tell the truth. Father, we thank you and we praise you for God, Lord, for that word that you sent on today. God, we just ask you to bless us, Lord, that when times come, Lord, to be truthful, that we will share the truth, Lord. We won't lie, but God will share the truth. We thank you again for what we've heard on today. God, we ask that you let us be a blessing everywhere we go, that, God, we will share the truth. Thank you again for this word, Lord. Just continue to bless our pastor. Bless this church family, Lord. We thank you again. For us in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Now, if you want to be a part of this congregation, I know you say we don't live in the same city, but we can still be a part of this congregation, not only financially, but you can be a part, Lord, spiritually. Now, we ask you again also if you want to give to the church, we use Giblify. You can use Giblify or you can write a check, put it in the mail, 17401 Joseph Campo, 48212. If you're looking for salvation, there's some instructions at the end of the service that'll help you, Lord, to get some information about not only giving, but salvation. We thank you. Hopefully you enjoyed the word. Hope you've been inspired. Of course, in Jesus' name, we thank you. In